Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the third part of my Eduard 148 scale F-104J Eiko build. So last time we completed most of the build and are now ready to move on. But before that, if you are enjoying the series, please do leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and keep yourself informed about the updates by clicking the bell icon. Right then, time to put together the cockpit instrument panel. Since the kit has a photo etch set that I will be using, I start off by grinding and sanding off all the detailing on the instrument panel. Finally, a little Tamiya cement to clean up any dust and sharpen the edges. The instrument panel parts are now painted with Mr. Color 308 Gray, which is the same color we used for the cockpit interior earlier. Time now to cut, clean and glue the photo etch parts in place. The first part I fix is the gun sight. Looks nice, but I need to paint this with the cockpit interior color. Now the instrument panel photo etch is fixed in place. Looks really nice. The fabric part of the front cover is painted with XF49 khaki. Lastly, some gloss varnish to protect the paint and ready it for a wash. Once the varnish is dry, I apply Tamiya's black panel line wash. The extra wash is later wiped away with a cotton bud moistened with odorless spirit. Lastly, a coat of matte varnish. The area behind the pilot seat is black. I just highlight the details here by dry brushing the areas with aluminium. The clear cockpit canopy parts are now cut and cleaned. The kit comes with a pre-cut masking set, and what a huge time saver these are. Also, they give a very good and clean finish. The vacant area between the masks is covered with masking fluid. Now it's time to glue in place the front and rear parts of the canopy. The areas that I painted earlier are now masked using tissue soaked in water. Some sponge for the air intakes. I usually keep the canopy open on my kits, but somehow I felt that keeping it open on this kit would take away from the streamlined shape of the aircraft, so I decided to close it. For now, I only attach the canopy temporarily for painting. I will only glue it in place in the end once the ejection seat has been installed. With the canopy in place, I give it a coat of interior grey Mr. Color. This is done so that the inside of the canopy matches the rest of the cockpit interior. I now give the entire kit a couple of coats of extreme metal black base. Finally, the base paint for the kit. I chose Tamiya's Lacquer Paints Gloss Aluminium, LP70. The first couple of layers of paint reveal some imperfections on the surface. These have to be cleaned up because on a metallic finish they will stand out. So I take a 2000 grit sanding sponge and smooth out all the imperfections. Another coat of Tamiya's Gloss Aluminium. There we go, much better. Time to mask the nose cone. A little protection for the fuselage as well, as the underside of the wings are to be painted the same color as the nose cone. For the color, I chose Mr. Color 315 Gray. Off comes the masking. All good so far. Now, some very fine and time-consuming masking for the anti-glare panel. These days, I favor really thin masking tape for the outlines and then broader tape to fill in the larger areas. I paint the area with Tamiya's XF61 dark green. Nice. There are more panels to be masked and painted. Once again, I use a thin masking tape to do the outline of the panel. Once the outline is done, I use a wider tape to complete the masking. To paint these panels, I am using Mr. Color 44 Tan. Now to mask off the areas with the white and red stripes. There is a lot of masking involved in such color schemes, but don't rush it. The more time you take masking, the less time you will spend correcting mistakes. The entire area is painted with Tamiya white. When the white paint dried, I found that there were some flaws in the finish, so I sanded them off with a 2000 grit sanding sponge and repainted the area. I let the white paint dry properly, then masked off the white area. The exposed surface will be painted red. I use Mr. Color 3. The intakes were masked and painted black. There were a few places where a tiny amount of red paint had come through the masking. I cleaned this up with a hand brush and some white paint. Right then, fellow model makers, there is still plenty to be done with the kit, but that will have to wait till the next edition. I know I am not as frequent with the videos as I used to be, but work is getting in the way. Still, I hope you are enjoying the build. Till next time, stay safe, good luck, and happy model making.